So continuing on my presentations of taking the feed to the switch, I've simulated here three lighting points that have the feed coming down to the switch, and in each case a switching line and neutral coming back. And we're now going to make a decision of how we're going to connect the neutrals together and the CPCs within the actual light switch itself. We've got some choices of the Wago or Insure, almost maintenance free style connectors, one with the levers and one with a straight push fit. We've got the standard 5-amp connector block as well as through crimps. So we're going to do three different styles of connections within the three switches and then work out which one of them is easier or not easier to make a connection for testing at the switch. So a couple of things in this presentation: how to make the connections for the neutrals and the CPCs using different styles, Insure, Wago, 5-amp connector blocks and through crimps. And then how can we get a testing connection within the switch to prove, say for instance, the CPC is present at the switch. So let's see how we're going to connect those switches up. So I'm going to make off one of the switches. I'll make off the first switch and then I'll progress and make some of the other connections off on the other switch so we can just show the connections for the neutrals and the CPCs at switches 2 and 3 without having to do the line conductors. So what we've got is one cable coming in, is bringing in the permanent line, a neutral and a CPC. And then the one going out is taking a switching line, neutral and CPC. We'll make off the connections into the back of the one-way switch, and then we'll make a decision how we're going to join together the neutrals and the CPC. So first of all, I'll just connect the permanent line and the switching line in the back of a one-way switch. I'll show you this set of wire strippers first, these combination wire strippers, which I don't allow my students to use because they are too easy. So this is the bit where they'll be absolutely fuming when I show them this. So I place my conductor in, it holds and pinches, and believe it or not, it removes the conductor's insulation. We'll do that again just to show you, we can take a little bit more off. And we pull it off and there we are. So we can now make a doubled over termination for the back of our switch. I'll do it again here, hold it into position. It clamps and holds and then just pulls away the outside insulation. I'll show you again. So we've got our conductors exposed. We don't do it like that in my college. We usually use a knife in order to score around and then we pull off the insulation. But just to show you that we can use a combination set of wire strippers. Still gonna need to double it over. So I take my pliers and I'm going to double over my terminations to go in the back of my light switch. Maybe just trim that one back a fraction and double that one over as well. And now we're ready to secure those terminations in the back of the one-way switch. Doesn't matter which one goes in common and which one goes in L1 at this stage. If they're the wrong way around, we'll just physically turn the switch up the other way to get the correct throw. So here we go. So there we have it. We've connected the permanent line and the switching line into the switch. I'm not going to screw it back yet because obviously we've got to terminate the neutrals and the CPCs. First one out, we're going to use the Wago style and the Insure style to connect these two together and see how simple they are. So let's do that next. So I've put my CPC sleeving on and my conductors are considerably longer than that required to go into either an Insure or a Wago connector. Now I'm going to do the same with the neutrals. I'm going to make them approximately the same length before we start. And it's suggested in both manufacturers' cases that you leave 11 mil. They try and give you a little bit of an aid. It'd be very difficult to see on here. There is actually a black line there denoting the length of 11 mil. And on this style one, they actually leave a recess in the top. So when you lay it in like so, if you cut the insulation back to that length, that also gives you the 11 mil required for this style of connector as well. So let's see if we can approximately do that. So this time I'm gonna do it more styled conventionally with my knife. Trim round. Like so. Now if I take this style here, I can just work out approximately what 11 mil is. I'm fractionally long on that one and fractionally long on that one. So just trim those back. And I can confirm it on the other style by laying it in there or laying it in like so, yeah, approximately 11 mil. So I'm gonna put my neutrals into the Insure style. A Wago make a similar one as well. Just wanted to use two different manufacturers. You lift the arms up. In both cases, this is a two-way one, so they will join the two together and push it into position and clip it down to clasp it. And then in again for the second one, and again, fully inserted before clasping down onto the conductors and they do not pull free. Wanting to release them, reverse the process and you can remove the conductor. Not quite the case with this style. This style on the Wago ones are one hit wonders, so once you've pushed them in, they're in position and held firm. I have chosen a four-way one this time, just in case I wanted to add another conductor in there. Obviously the two that would already be in there would be fastened into position and not be able to be removed, so you'd have to cut it off and change the style. So I've gave two spare ones this time. So I need to trim it down to 11 mil. So if I offer it, I can see how much roughly to cut off. Cut it back to about there. In both cases. And now I simply push it into position nice and firmly, like so. And then this one, push it in and it firmly grasps those connections. Okay, both in and firm and secured. I've left two spare ones and they've grasped nice and tight. So we've used what they class as maintenance-free connectors. We've got the Insure type and the Wago type holding now my CPCs together, so joining those two together and joining my two neutrals together. So that's the first style of connector that we could use in the back of the switch itself. I'm going to make off the other two switches and just concentrate on how we're going to join the CPCs and neutrals together in the next part of the presentation. So switch position 2 and 3 are now prepared and ready to go. I'm going to use a standard 5-amp connector block for the connecting the two CPCs and the two neutrals together. So two connector blocks to go into this one, just a brass block with two screws at the top to pinch together or squeeze together the two terminations. So CPCs go into the 5-amp connector block and we simply tighten it down to both screws. And we take one for the neutrals and we join those two together as well. Like so. So we've screwed together the two neutrals in this side and the two CPCs here, and again these can be positioned in the back of the switch itself. So we've used first of all our maintenance freestyle ones, Insure and Wago, and now we've used the standard sort of 5-amp connector blocks that are widely used. Final one we're going to use now is a through crimp, so I'll get ready for that next. Next I'm using a red through crimp, red for 1 to 1.5mm cable. I'm using 1mm cable and we insert the conductors one in each side, so one in from one side and one in from the other. And just got to be careful now to make sure we get our crimping tool with a section that will crimp. So in this case there's a little dot on this one which is the bit that crimps the tube, and then there's no markings on the other side that just squashes up the plastic this side. So holding the conductors together, I crimp one side, I turn it round, so I've gone from that position there, I've spun it round, making my dot section this side, and I crimp up this section here, give them a little tug, just to see that they're held together, they are, and I'll repeat the process again now for my CPCs. One in from one side, one in from the other side, making sure my crimping tool, got my dot in this case, for the centre section, spin it through, crimp up again. So now I've got my crimp connections on this one. So maintenance free style, Insure and Wago, 5-amp connector blocks and through crimps. Now there's three differing methods that we can join together our two neutrals and our two CPCs in each of our lighting switching points that we've had a feed drop down to it. So we've dropped down line and neutral and CPC, and we've come out from the switch with a switching line, neutral and CPC. So we've had to join together the two CPCs and together the two neutrals, fully insulated switches, so the switches themselves don't need to be connected to the CPC at this stage. Let's see how we're going to go about now making a continuity of CPC test at the switch now that we've got through crimps, 5-amp connectors and maintenance freestyle ones in the next part of the presentation. So I'm ready to prove continuity of CPC at my switch. In initial verification, you need to prove continuity of CPC at all points. Also that it could be changed in the future for an exposed conductive part that would be required to be connected to the CPC. Zeroed out my leads and I'm going to prove the CPC makes it to the way to the switch. So we go into the top connection, which in this case is the common, and we go into the connector block and I have a reading of 0.12 of an ohm, therefore proving continuity of CPC to the switching point itself. Let's see how easy it's going to be when I move across to the maintenance freestyle connectors next. problem I've got now is that these tips are too large to make the connections inside either the Wago or the Insure style one. So we're going to have to change one of these tips for a considerably smaller tip that will allow us to make a connection, in this case on the top surface of this style connection and inside of the Wago one, in order to make a connection for the CPC. So we're going to have to change our probe tip, and we're going to have to remove the resistance of the lead before we make a connection and try and prove the continuity of CPC at this light switch. So I'm going to attempt to probe on in both positions in order to get a realistic reading. So into the top of the common and into the top of the connection itself. My reading is, when it settles in, I've got 0.15 of an ohm, proving continuity to this connection. It's not the easiest connection to make with these probes. I do prefer the top entry style ones. They're a little bit easier, but I'm sure some practice you'll be able to make a connection in order to connect either, in this case, to the CPC and line, in order to get a continuity test. Let's see how we're going to do it with the through crimps in the next stage. So once again, to get into the actual connection here for the CPC, I'm going to use my thin probe. Hopefully I can just slide it past the conductor and catch hold of the conductor, and then go on to the top of the switch to get a reading of 0.09 for the continuity CPC at this switching point. I've got approximately the same amount of cable at each circuit. There isn't a lot of difference in the resistance of the joints, so it's just the cable length that I've inserted to each of the switching points. So we've seen how we can make a continuity CPC test relatively easy, obviously with the 5 amp connector, a little bit more difficult when we're using the maintenance free one, and we've managed to modify the same sort of technique in order to connect into the through crimp in order to prove continuity CPC at these points. I hope this video has been some help.